Welcome back everybody. In this video we'll be showcasing the one-handed hammer and the handgun. So, a tale of hammers and handguns. First, let's take a look at our traits. On my hammer, I have killing blow on the normal attack, regrowth on the normal attack, and off balance. Decent trait combination for this weapon. No scavenger on it, but you don't really need scavenger with handguns too much, which is what I'm using. With my handgun, I have bloodlust, ammo holder for those extra shots, which is also questionable whether you actually need that on handguns, depending on how fast your group moves, but anyway. And Hawkeye. Not necessarily ideal traits, kind of a playstyle thing. I like having ammo holder. I don't know why. I like making sure that I will always have some shots for whatever comes. Alright, as far as changes to the weapons, let's start with the hammer first. So, version 1.5, one really significant change is that the light attack on this now hits infinite targets, minus the fourth attack in the chain, I believe it is. So, let's see. Infinite targets, infinite targets, infinite targets, and then that downward strike, the fourth strike, that only hits one target. As you can see, it comes top to bottom, so it's a decent chance to get a head strike, but the only hitting one target is almost a deal breaker if you're fighting in a group of rats. So what I recommend folks do is the three attacks, or maybe, I'd say the first three attacks, and then just being aware of the swing pattern on the third attack being not quite as wide of an arc. And then blocking out or shoving for the last attack. So 1, 2, 3, block. 1, 2, 3, block, like that. Or 1, 2, 3, shove. 1, 2, 3, shove, like that. That's how I recommend folks use this weapon, just because of the fact that all of those first three attacks have infinite targets, and you're less likely to take damage if you are at least staggering everything. We'll test this on storm vermin, but I also believe that the light attack is actually capable of staggering storm vermin as long as they're not doing an attack animation. Which means that if the storm vermin is by itself, you actually could keep staggering with this and then pop with that last attack, look up a little bit and get some headshot damage on him. They did up the damage on that last attack in this patch from 3 damage to 4 damage, and it does have a headshot multiplier. Let me see what it is. The headshot multiplier for this is, oh, it's times 2 on the first two swings, and then the third and fourth, it's only plus 1, so not too big a deal. That's the hammer. It's a lot of fun now, especially with its infinite target limit and the fact that you can run a little bit faster while blocking now. This thing's it's a good time. Handgun. Now, the handgun, unlike most other weapons, received some nerfs this last patch. So, this beauty here used to be pretty much king. It's still really good. If you like the playstyle of handgun, I don't recommend that you stop using it. But the biggest change I think people are upset about is that you can no longer body shot Packmasters on Cataclysm with this. You can body shot them on Nightmare, which is where I think the game is most fun anyway. But it went from 40 damage to resistant damage types, which the Packmaster and Rat Ogre fall into that category. But in order to kill, it went from, so I said 40 to 35, and the Packmaster has 40 hit points, therefore, like I said, you can't just pop and kill a Packmaster with a body shot anymore. You now have to aim, or get lucky with a hip shot, or not move with a hip shot and get, you know, a decent chance of getting a headshot, and get a headshot. This thing has a pretty nice headshot multiplier, if memory serves. Let's see. Yeah, it's times 2. So, with the high damage that it does, they didn't change the damage values to any other damage types besides resistance. Now, Another thing that they changed, that this thing used to do pathetic friendly fire damage, and in this patch, most weapons do pathetic friendly fire damage, but now the handgun actually does some of the most friendly fire damage. It does 10, which is equal to a, actually, that might just be the top. Anything else do 10? Charge level 3 bolt staff. Also does 10 damage. So this is now the highest friendly fire damage weapon in the game. So there's that to consider. I'm not going to bother refilling for one ammo. Let's get this show on the road. We've talked enough here. Show you how this works out. Get my bombs. Get my potions. They can kill all the little rats because it's funny.
At least it's
quicker than walking. Alright. So, good to see this thing in action.
The city so forlorn. It's a charm to these human settlements.
I'm not sure I see it. You've traveled to many of them?
One or two. Löwenhof was my favorite. Strong ale, trusting folk, heavy purses.
So you robbed them? Ah, there may be hope for you yet.
Healing draft.
I like banter in this game. I do have bomb radius, so let's put it to good use. Come over here, bots.
It's not bumpins, I'll
there
that.
We go. Alright, 1, 2, 3, push. 1, 2, 3. We're good. Oh, I forgot to mention the heavy attack of this thing. Very fast charge time. It does 10 damage, which is enough to kill a Cataclysm land rat, so that's nice, and that's to of course the unarmored rat damage types. It does 30 damage with a does 30 damage with a to the resistant damage type, which once again is not enough to kill a packmaster. So you can't just overhead melee a packmaster with this thing. Now, it's enough to kill one on Nightmare. Which, once again, I think the game's most fun on Nightmare, so... I'll show you how to use a handgun nicely, but the handgun does kill up to 3 targets now. It used to kill up to 4 on the last patch, so it doesn't pierce quite as much as it used to. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, push. 1, 2, 3, push. Oop. Of course, he's climbing out of a window, which means you can't stagger them. Pain in the butt. I understand why they did it. It would make it way too easy for certain areas to be defended in the game, bordering on exploit. Now, this light attack does only damage the first 2 targets normally. Which normally would be an issue. Just actually, it's oh well. Gruber is killing Glowing off. Let's melee this guy. Come on. Let's melee this guy. Oh. Miss. Swing and a miss. I'm gonna have to redeem myself later. Bop, bop. There we go. There's the down attack. The down attack will hit Storm Room. Alright. So he already body shotted him. So I was gonna have no problem body shotting him too. The 2 handgun shots will body shot a Storm Room, and a headshot will kill them. This is on Nightmare Man the Ramparts. If you're not familiar with my videos, this is my map that I like to test on. Now, if you saw what I did there, I went swing, push, and then you can go straight back to the start. So when you do the push or the shove, it doesn't just take one of the attacks out of your chain and put you right back where you were before. It actually resets the chain, meaning that you can just do the first 2 swings, which have the nicest swing pattern, if you want to. That. So right there, that's what happens if you don't swing enough. You're gonna have to do a shove to make sure you don't take damage. If you don't swing enough, you don't wait enough between your swings. It'll keep going with the chain. Now if I shove right now, it will still, once again, reset the combo. So you can do the full combo, including the downward strike. Do a safety shove because you just made yourself vulnerable to the possibility of multiple rats hitting you. And continue on with the nice swings on the chain. So the way that they designed this is very friendly to anybody wanting to use this weapon. It's nice. Like, unlike the hammer for, say, I think the Bright Wizard that has the awkward first strike, I believe, with the mace, which I didn't even do a video on, because I never used that weapon. I can do one if you folks want, but, bop. Here we go. So, yeah. So, it is staggering him. So I am able to stagger that Storm Vermin, which is nice. Let's protect the Carillion bot because she's terrible. I could have done a downward strike because there's only one bot or one rat. Got stabbed in the back. So a periodic shove isn't a bad idea anyway, even if you do have a nice, oh jeez, freaking upward attack pattern. Bap, 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 bap. There you go. Carillion's nice and thirsty. And of course I leave this bot for a second. She takes a bunch of damage. Annoying. But they gave us lots of bombs. From a good use. Back with all these guys. Alright, so this handgun. Nice thing about it is infinite range. You can pop Storm Vermin with a hit scan weapon in the head for days. There's two. One of his buddies coming now. Oh, bad, I missed. I hit him, but it was a body shot. There we go. Oh, another thing they nerfed, if you can't tell by looking at the screen, is the, actually, you can't tell because I don't have Mastercrafted, but they did nerf the damage of, or the reload time. Oh, the wall instead. Oh well, let's do some charge attacks on these ones. So one of them I've hit. That. Oh god, this is a bad situation, isn't it? Okay, assassin's dead. Now, the overhead strike is single target. The one, two. It does have the headshot. Let's take him out. I'm not gonna run over there with my hammer. Alright, so the charge shot, like I said, does 10 damage to unarmored. To armor targets, it does 4.5 with a plus 1 headshot modifier, meaning that it will do enough damage. Actually, I haven't tested this. If I make sure I get headshots to see how many kills you can get. I mean, if you can kill them with 2 headshots or 3. Because what trips me up is that 0.5. They have 14 health total. So, you'd think that you need at least 3 hits to kill them. Where's this stupid line at? There we go. So you'd think that you need 3 hits to kill it because you gotta, you know, get up to about 15 or whatever. Let's get going. Yeah, let's test that out. Now with the infinite targets, just a little tip about traits, the kill on, or the chance to kill any man-sized target on a hit, regular hit, is very nice because this thing does hit infinite targets, and I believe that you can proc this trait off of any hit, not just damage hits. I could be wrong on that. I don't look at the code. I just play the game and have a good time for the most part. But I do like knowing some of the numbers. Let's see. Fill my ammo. Huck a bomb because I have it. Nothing spawned up there yet. Oh well. Didn't see any little. You are doing damage ticks. Oh, come on, Kruber. Oh, piss something off. Ah. So yeah, can't stagger them out. You cannot stagger them out of their attack animations, it looks like. I tried to do a light attack when he was attacking, and it didn't stagger him at all, so. Tested. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Good shove, just in case. Man, what are you doing, Kruber? What are you doing, Kruber? Uh-huh. Coming for your ass. Oh. Ah. Dang it, I wish I'd known he was coming. I was gonna try to redeem myself with a melee kill. Oh, I think I missed the head. I hit the head of the little rat instead. Nope. Aim for downward strikes. Going as hell. Bop. So, better runner down. Here comes the storm vermin that I missed. Oh, here comes two storm vermin apparently. Okay, there's a body shot on one. There's a downward strike that I couldn't see coming. There we go. What a shit. Good grief. They're just hammering us right here. My goodness. My goodness. So angry. Bop, 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 bop. Okay. Lots of rats dead. There's a globe red up. Let's make sure I got one in the chamber. Oh yeah, I think I got interrupted when I was saying that the, oh, good grief. Of course, when I turned to shoot, that's when the thing peeks its head out. They did nerf Mastercrafted. It used to be a pretty much mandatory trait on this weapon. It used to increase reload speed to 50%, and you used to be able to do an active reload. Meaning that if you hit the reload key at a certain time, or oftentimes just spammed it, it would work. One, two. So two charged attacks will kill a globe rat, apparently, with a hammer. I believe one regular attack would do it, too. I'm trying to reload here. So it does take a while, as you can see. Very long reload on this weapon. Now, let's see. One. God damn it, Carillion, and your killing blow. Healer's tools. There it is. I don't even know where it came from. Alright. Six myself up. Alright, I was attacking somebody else, so it's fine. No good, we're getting a horde on top of a horde, and we haven't even started the event yet, so I could make this crazy. Let's do it. Oh, Carillion's doing it for me. Let's get some rats up in this. Block. You just need to do a quick block. You don't need to hold it for long whenever you're trying to reset. Aw. Killing rats trays. Blocked. That's why you do that block, just in case you're bad like me and you occasionally miss your downward strikes, like I did on that Packmaster at the start of the video. Oh good, they're chasing a special for days. Alright. Alright, that went fine. So yeah, this is the one-handed weapon of choice for controlling and clearing hordes, if you happen to have the killing blow. So I was able to kill a lot of that, and I was able to control a lot of that just with light attacks. And the fact that it has a nice heavy attack for doing like heavier damage, armor piercing, all that stuff, makes us a good all-around weapon. Good for controlling hordes, good for clearing hordes, good for killing specials. Bop, out of the body shot. Yeah, there's three. Definitely takes three on body shots. My question is on headshots. But We already established that I seem to have trouble with my headshots. Or even hitting those. Let's see if I can body shot this guy. Oh, she took care of him.
We need to go this way.
Care of them. Come on, rats, as Mr. Barden says. 1, 2, 3 kills. Kills for days. Infinite targets, getting my heals. Works nice. If you can get regrowth and whatever the heck you want, you're pretty good. Oh, I should have tested a hammer on him. Sorry, reflex. Just wanted to pop him. The reason I did the handgun with the hammer in this video is because the handgun's probably not particularly interesting. There's people that are pretty butthurt about some of the changes to its ability to kill Packmasters, but I don't know. Fulfills the same role to me. Not a particularly interesting weapon, it's just hit scan, plenty of damage. If you're a good shot, then you are credited to team. If you miss a lot, then you are punished by a humongous reload time. Even with Mastercrafted, it still takes quite a bit of time to reload. Let's block to reset, just in case. Boom. See some swings coming in. 1, 2, 3. Just in case there's a rat behind me still. Bop, bop, bop. Yep. Good times ahead by all. First run, I was doing what I was practicing with this weapon a little bit. At almost zero damage. Unfortunately, this run is not like that. I got hit by that storm vermin at the ramp coming into the tower, so far from zero damage. I think I've lost almost an entire health bar this game, so oh well. But you can defend yourself very well with this weapon. Occasionally something bad might happen to you, whatever, but you're good. You're better than me. You can defend yourself no problem. What the heck just hit her so hard? Why did she just lose so much health? There was like no rats around her. Alright, melee time. Fuck these storm vermin. Bam! Ah, too bad Kruger got his killing blow off. So, respectable damage as you can see there. Fast charge. Killing chain objectives and things like that. Goes pretty fast with this. I'll do a downward strike there for fun. Bop, there's another fun downward strike. Anything else you gotta worry about? Bop, bop, bop. Oh, 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 oh. Can it happen? Yeah. So as you can see there, you can kill the Packmaster if you hit him before he grabs you. Hello? Oh, dodge that. Two, yeah. So that was two head... Oh, damn, I missed my third hit. So that was two headshots. You cannot kill a storm vermin with two headshots. Unfortunately. Let's go down here. Do the safety way. Doop, doop, doop. Pow. So, if there's three or less rats, you can just... And running at you in a line like that, you can just quick switch your handgun and kill him really easy if you want. Anyway, good times head by Hall. Tale of hammers and handguns. See if we get anything good. Hope you all had a good holiday. XP and to get some orange shards or not this time. Hey, what do you know? One-handed sword for elf. Not a bad weapon, but I already have one that is darn near a perfect roll as far as I'm concerned. Yeah. Cool. That's for anyone who cares. Yeah. Whoop-de-doo. So now you're not going to get a ton of range kills using the handgun. Reload's way too slow. I guess I could show you the difference real quick in the inn for for the Mastercrafted trait. I should have shown that at the beginning. Alright, so, let's see. Where's she at? There, this one has Mastercrafted. So, you can compare again. So, once again, ow, reload. Takes a little while, right? Handgun with Mastercrafted unlocked. Pow. Still takes a while. It's a little bit faster. 25% faster, to be precise. With no active reloading. Means that Mastercrafted still is kind of eh. It's not bad. Certainly not a bad trait, but it's not as good as it used to be. Not as mandatory. Anyway. Hope y'all, like I said, had a good holiday, and we'll catch you in the next video. Cheers.